Staying alive, staying alive. Hey, it's your girl Veronica Harris, and today we have news you can use. Yes, we are going to be talking about how to save lives, CPR. And in case you don't know what CPR stands for, you will learn about that today here on the Veronica Harris Show. Staying alive, staying alive. Staying alive, staying alive. Going to be saving lives because it's important to save lives because the life you save may be your own. And today we have two great people who are going to help us learn how to save lives. Today we have Miss Robin Green.
Hi. How are you?
And we have Miss Brianna Brooks.
How are you doing?
Great. And these two young ladies are going to help us learn CPR. Now, Miss Robin, tell us about yourself, your background, what do you do, so forth and so on.
I'm a paramedic. With DC Fire and EMS. I'm with a team called Street Calls Mobile Integrated Healthcare Team. And what we do is we go around the city and we help our citizens learn CPR.
Okay, now when exactly did this program begin?
This program, Hands on Hearts, started in October 2015, in which we started the program, and so far we've toured probably over 50,000 people.
So you've trained over 50,000 people with the Hands on Hearts program.
Yes.
Okay, and we have Miss Brianna Brooks. Are you also a part of the Hands on Heart program?
No, I'm not.
Oh, okay, but you're just here to help.
Yes.
Okay, you're just here to help. All right, cool, we got it. All right, so like I said, I was telling our audience out there that today we're gonna learn about CPR. Now, a lot of times people are afraid to do CPR, or they're afraid to help someone who may be in some sort of medical distress because they think there's some legal issues involved. That is not the case, correct?
Correct. There are good Samaritan laws out here that will cover you. As a matter of fact, there's two of them.
Oh, there's really two? Okay.
Two
I always thought there was just one.
There's two laws that will cover you being a good Samaritan.
So basically that means as long as you're acting in good faith.
Correct.
And you're not doing anything that's like, you're not trying to perform surgery and you're not a doctor. You're just giving basic help.
Not being malice to the person, trying to help them.
All right, so as long as you're acting in good faith, trying to give help and aid to the person, you're okay.
Yes, ma'am.
All right, awesome. Now, we have here some equipment. Back in the day, we used to call this Recessor Annie. This doesn't look like Annie anymore.
Yeah, she's pretty small now. Yeah. She's lost a lot of weight, but we still have the big ones, but for demo purposes today, we have the small mannequin. It's easier to carry, and it does the same purpose.
The same purpose.
Teach people how to save lives.
Okay, so it's basically a dummy that's pretty much anatomically correct from the head down to, I guess, the middle part of the torso. And this is what you use to instruct people on not just CPR, but also in the use of the AED.
Yes. That's correct.
Okay, and the AED stands for, just for people who don't know?
Automated External Defibrillator.
All right, so in other words, this little machine here can actually save a life because if the heart should come out of rhythm, it can help get the heart back into rhythm.
It shocks it tries to shock your heart back into its normal rhythm.
Right, and I've seen this in action. I've actually, at the school where I teach, one of the teachers actually was able to save a kid's life with the AED. So we didn't always have AEDs in school. This is really a relatively new thing, I guess, within the past 10 years. But they do help and they do save lives. So it's really important. Now, who can learn CPR? Is it for just certain people? Can anybody do it? I know as a teacher, I'm required to know CPR. Usually people that work with kids have to know CPR. But who can, like, out of our citizens in the D.C. area, who can learn this?
Anybody.
Anybody?
Anybody.
Okay. My little niece who's 11, she can learn it?
Yes.
Okay.
And American Heart has broken it down into four simple steps. And it's not, it's like the traditional CPR, but they've skipped steps. And as a citizen, when I show you, you won't have a mouthpiece like the traditional CPR.
Right, so there's no mouth to mouth.
Right, because a lot of people are afraid to put their mouths on people because they don't know people's circumstances.
Of course, mm-hmm. Universal precautions.
Yes, mm-hmm. What we call. So this is just a new way of helping someone.
Because research has shown it's more important that we keep the blood circulating to keep the brain oxygenated, so forth and so on. And that can really only be done through compressions.
Correct. Correct. Okay. Correct. All right. The AEDs are in all public buildings now. This sign here, usually you will see an AED, the machine right under that. Mm-hmm. And you can, if someone says, hey, someone's unresponsive and, you know, we're doing CPR, go get the AED. You usually can find them mm-hmm. easier because they usually have the sign up above it, mm-hmm. like an exit sign.
Okay.
And the machine right there. And you just go there and pull it.
Okay. Well, we don't want to give too much away because we're going to save that for the next segment as far as like, because you're going to actually coach me through like a little scenario on what to do and everything. But just really quickly, because we do have a little bit more time left. Mm-hmm. I see right here on one of your handy dandy cheat sheets, as I like to call them. Okay. You really do break it down into really three. Well, if you get the AED, four steps. But in terms of what you have to do, because I remember taking a test. It was like the ABCs and remember this and do that. I was like, how am I going to remember to do all that? Mm-hmm. But they really do make a good idea of just showing you, breaking it down, like what you have to do. And they also give you illustrations. So if you're one of those visual learners like myself, you know, you get that instruction here as well as it's really simple instructions. And it really is become from step one was this check and call, meaning checking and then making that call. And then the chest compressions. And the most important thing is don't stop. Now, when they say don't stop, what exactly are they talking about? Like, how long should you go for?
Well, they want you to continue the compressions as long as you can, as long as you can do them, as long as there's nothing life-threatening that would hurt or harm you mm-hmm. While you're trying to help that person. Mm-hmm. Not when you hear a fire truck or ambulance come down the street, because it may not be your ambulance or fire truck.
Right.
So not until they get right here and say, thank you, mm-hmm. well done. When in 2015, when our mayor said, hey, the numbers are down in our DC area right. and we've got to do something. Our fire chief, Gregory Dean, says, hey, we're going to
create this app for it called Pulse Point.
Well, that was created a little bit down the road.
Okay.
But he says, hey, we're going to send you guys out and I want you to teach our citizens how to so that we can bring our numbers up in the district. And those people or the citizens won't be afraid to call 911 and administer the CPR to that person until we can get there.
Okay.
Then a little bit down the road, we came up with this thing called Pulse Point.
You know how they say there's an app for that? Well,
yeah,
here's
an app.
App to help you save a life.
You can put the citizens can put this on their phone,
uh-huh.
and it's called Pulse Point.
Mm-hmm.
It will notify you. Your phone will like sort of buzz or notify you when there's a CPR in your area.
Oh.
I don't know what radius it picks up, how many miles or what have mm-hmm. you, but it will say there's a CPR and give your address, mm-hmm. the address it is. And
you can go
there and do CPR, hands on heart, CPR mm-hmm. on that person until 911 gets there.
Wow, so this really, it's almost like they took the medical alert little thing that they have where you say, help, I'm falling, I can't get up. They've taken a little step further and given more, I guess, empowered the citizens
yes.
to actually help.
Yes, because the sooner you jump on that heart and start those
right.
compressions, the better outcome that patient may have
exactly.
until 911 gets there.
Because I'm sure the fire department has, you know, great response time, but, you know, it could be traffic or something could have happened. So,
yes.
Oh my God, this is really good. And the mayor and our government has, you know, helped us, you know, help create this for us. Yeah. So when they say there's an app for that, there really is an app for this. Okay, great. So we are up against our first break now, and we are going to stop. But when we come back, you are going to help coach me through how to save a life. Hopefully I do good. I try to pride myself on being a good student as well as a good teacher. So if you stay right here, we'll be right back and we'll help you save a life.
It's a short ride from your neighborhood to your naturehood. To find a neighborhood park or green space near you, visit discovertheforest.org.
If your heart stopped beating today, who would save your life? Every year, more than 350,000 people in the United States have a cardiac arrest outside the hospital, someplace where professional medical help is not immediately available. At home, on the bus, in classrooms like the one at your school. And about 90% of those people don't survive. That's over 850 people dying from cardiac arrest every day. But when trained bystanders perform hands-only CPR until professional help arrives, their efforts can actually triple someone's chances of surviving a cardiac arrest.
And now it's time for the most important part of our show, the demonstration. So yes. Paramedic Green is going to briefly take us through a demonstration of how to do some basic CPR. But before we do that, real quickly, not everybody when they're growing up says, I want to be a paramedic. You do hear firefighter, you may hear a policeman, teacher, astronaut, superhero. What made you decide to be a paramedic?
As a young woman, there was an accident on my street. Mm-hmm. And DC Fire and EMS came to facilitate. They were called, 911 was made, call was made to them. And I stood out there and I watched the injury, the person that was injured, and they came to the rescue and they did all kinds of awesome things, and mm-hmm. I thought it was just cool. And, you know, in my later years, I said, hey, I always thought about it, but I was like, nah. And I decided, hey, I don't want to say I wish I would have. Yeah. So I went back to school. I went to UDC mm-hmm. and took the EMT course mm-hmm. and applied with DC Fire.
And
here I am. And after 6 years, I decided, hey, let's upgrade because I want to do some other things with DC Fire. I decided to become a paramedic and I went back to school again uh-huh. and got my paramedic license. So okay. here I am.
All right. And just so people know, EMT stands for Emergency Medical Technician, and they do more of the basic life-saving skills, and
yes.
paramedic, which is what you are, you do more advanced, like you can actually administer drugs.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, mm-hmm. awesome. All right, so let's get to it. So what do you teach me? Okay, instruct me on how to do some CPR. And for those of you that don't know, CPR stands for cardiopulmonary resuscitation, correct?
Correct.
All right, see, I'm a good student. I paid attention. All right, let's go.
So there are four steps that I want to teach you. Four C's. Check, check, call, compress.
Check, check, call, compress. Check,
four
check,
steps.
Okay.
The first one is to check that scene mm-hmm. because you want to be safe in trying to help someone.
Okay.
You want to make sure your surroundings is safe because you don't want to be in arm's way. You don't know what happened to that person. Say okay. you walk up on the sidewalk and you see them laying there.
So I'm walking up. Oh, person on the sidewalk.
Right. Check your surroundings. You don't know what happened to them. They maybe check. Had a medical emergency. Maybe they fell on the sidewalk on a, you know, the street uneven. Maybe they had a medical emergency. Or maybe something else, you know.
So
we
once,
just don't know.
Right. So once I check the scene, make mm-hmm. sure there's no dangerous objects, no hazardous mm-hmm. objects around. Mm-hmm. Okay, the scene looks safe. I come in and I approach. Next, mm-hmm. then what do I do?
Then if you deem that it's safe, we will move to your next C. Mm-hmm. Check.
Check.
Check again. Check that person. So you tap them on the shoulder. Hey, are you all right? Hey, are you okay? No response.
Okay, do we also check for a pulse at that time?
No.
No.
This
okay.
is for laymen because laymen's or citizens take too long. Do I feel a pulse? Do I not feel a pulse?
And they're nervous too. They're nervous.
Okay. Yes, yes. So if that person does not move, does not do anything, does not blink, do anything, most likely they're not breathing, because not too many people going to let you tap them on their chest without doing anything, any type of movement.
They may come up swinging like, hey, you know, yes. You got to watch out.
So we move to our third C, call 911. And most people have cell phones.
Yes,
you just pull your cell phone out.
That ICE number.
Call 911.
Yes,
put it on speaker. Mm-hmm. Put it right down there beside you. But if you're with, me and you are out, mm-hmm. and after we did our second check, mm-hmm. I could say, Veronica, go call 911
and get the
AD.
Okay.
So, but if you're by yourself, you put it on speaker. Okay. You tell them where you are. Hey. This is operator 456. What's your emergency? Hey, someone's not breathing. I'm at XYZ Street. Can you see send an ambulance or emergency response? Mm-hmm. And as you're saying that, we're wasting time. I want you to pull up the blouse, the bra.
Rip it if we have to.
Everything. So you can see this chest right mm-hmm. here. Okay?
Okay.
Now, once we get that open, the bra, everything. Just pull it up. Right here in the center of the chest is the sternum.
Correct.
Okay. We want to take your heel of your most dominant hand mm-hmm. and place it right there. Cup it with your other hand. Lock and load your hands mm-hmm. like this off the chest. And we want you to push maybe inch to inch and a half.
Okay. So let's just do a quick little back up a little bit. Mm-hmm. So we've checked everything. Somebody's called 911 or I got on my phone speaker. I told them where I am. Not necessarily who I am, but where I am, please send help. Mm-hmm. We've got the shirt open. Rip it if we have to. Oh, well, I'm sorry. If it was a Dolce & Gabbana, we just have to keep going. All right, and then we find the sternum.
Right.
And place our
And that's
heel.
Right in the center of the chest.
Right, and place mm-hmm. our heel of our hand mm-hmm. on it.
Move up just a little bit.
Okay.
Come up just a little bit.
Oh, no.
There you go.
Clearly, I didn't study anatomy.
There you go.
But anyway, and then do we want to lock our elbows?
Yes.
Okay,
and
lock our
push.
Elbows. And we need
Heart
to be
fast.
Over the chest. We can't be.
Yes.
Okay, form is mm-hmm. important.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so this is where I am. All right, now you go back.
Okay. So
what's next?
We have a theme song that we used because we want you to do 100 to 120 beats a minute. Mm-hmm. And that song is Staying Alive. American Heart
has. So appropriate.
Yes, has endorsed that. So I'm going to play that so we can get the real feeling here.
Okay.
Okay. So, 911's been called, and I'm doing compressions. I've done my four C's here.
Okay.
I've checked the person, checked the scene, checked the person, called 911. Now I'm doing compressions, and you want to continue to do that to that beat.
Now, if you are with somebody, say we are together and you get tired, do I then step in if you get tired?
Yes, you do. We're going to bring the AED in and show you how to do that. That person works around me. Okay. Hey, Brianna, got the AED? Thank you.
I'm just going to step out the way and let them do their thing.
The patient's bare chest.
She works around me. Listen to all the prompts, because that AD tells you exactly what to do. I'm the heart for that person, so I don't stop.
Bypass. Plug-in connector. Analyzing heart rhythm. Do not touch the patient. Shocked advised.
I'm clear.
Charging.
You're clear. Everyone's clear.
We all have to
clear
be clear.
Of patient.
That sheen tells you everything
deliver
to do.
Deliver shock now. Press the orange shock delivered. Paused. Begin CPR.
And at that time, I'm tired from doing CPR. She can take over. This machine is going to pick up in 2 minutes and tell her analyze again. And that's where she's going to stop again. And if she's tired, I'm going to take over.
My turn. No,
yes.
No, my turn.
Yes. In 2 minutes.
Oh, my turn.
going to tell you, and you just continue that. That gives you 100 to 120 beats a minute
and
for
in
that
my
person.
Head, and in my head, I got Staying Alive going on. I'm like, staying alive, staying alive. Please stay alive, please stay alive. Please stay alive. You don't realize how long 2 minutes is
until. It feels very long.
Until.
And it's going to tell you to stop in 2 minutes. It's going to analyze and it's looking for some rhythms mm-hmm. in order to shock the heart.
Come on, AED.
If it says no shock advised, continue CPR, that's what you're going to do. That machine tells you everything to do.
Okay, well, I'm going to stop because, you know, unfortunately, the time for the show doesn't wait for the AED. But when we come back, we'll kind of do like a little quick recap. But I mm-hmm. think this was very good. I think we saw very clearly what to do. And the AED, you know, you hate to say anything is foolproof, but it almost is.
Mm-hmm. You can't mess up. You can't mess up. The pads tell you exactly where to place them on that patient. Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. And that person works around you, and it prompts you to do everything.
Okay. All okay. right. Well, that was a very good demonstration. Thank you, Ms. Brianna Brooks. Okay. You helped save. Did we say, yes, we saved the patient, just in case you know, you wanted to
we
know.
We saved the patient.
We saved the patient. And you know what? We're going to be right back.
Moments you share with your best friend, the greatest could be the moment you save her life. Every second counts in cardiac arrest. Learn hands-only CPR and be the difference for someone you love.
Just to wrap up our demonstration, what else can you? What else do we need to know about the AED?
Okay.
The important things we need to know.
The four steps, four C's, check, check, call, compress.
Okay.
Okay, so check the person, check the scene. Check the scene, check the person, call 911 and compress. Mm-hmm. If there's an AED in the facility or the building or the area, go get that. Mm-hmm. Another thing, who can... like
receive the AED.
Yes.
Right? Could you just put it on anybody? Like, I'm pretty sure
have
you can't
to be
put it on a baby.
8 years or over.
Okay.
Who can receive the hands on hearts.
Okay.
Okay. And not the traditional CPR. You have to be 8 years or over or show signs of puberty. Mm-hmm. That's it.
Okay. And it, say if we do come across a younger person, maybe we're in elementary school mm-hmm. and there's an AED or we're around elementary mm-hmm. Age kids. Mm-hmm. There are specific pads for actually an infant and a child.
Right.
So they're a different size.
Right.
And it would be in the AED.
Yes, they mm-hmm. should be in the AED. Mm-hmm. Some facilities, if they order it, yes.
Okay.
They will be there. Mm-hmm. We have smaller pads for children, baby pads.
Oh, yeah, they are pretty small in comparison.
And with comparison to that, because they don't give the whole 360 joules to that person. We call this attenuator, where it cuts the shock down for children. When you use an AED, you can use it in a snow puddle or snow. but not rain. Say you pull that person out of a bathtub, you want to wipe their chest off, and then apply the pads,
right,
because water and electricity don't mix.
Okay.
So you want to dry them off, top half, take a shirt, anything you can find. Mm-hmm. Some people have
hairy chests.
So we usually put a razor in there where we
quickly
shave the portions that we're going to put the
right.
AD
there.
Not the
whole chest.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then we put that on there because usually with that pad, it sticks up if your person is very hairy.
Mm-hmm.
If someone has a patches, medicine patch.
Or pacemaker.
Like sticky patches. Like some people have medicine patches,
right.
Hypertension patches, smoking patches.
Or what if they do have a pacemaker?
Then I'm going to tell you about
okay.
that too. Take a piece of their clothing and rip it off because those things are transdermal and they go through your skin.
Mm-hmm.
So if they have a hypertension patch on, you don't want to pull it off with your hands because it's going to go through your system and you know, knock your blood pressure down.
Okay.
So you take a piece of clothing, rip that off, and wipe it off, and then put the pads there.
Nice.
Say they have a pacemaker or inside, it usually looks like a little dime up here in the chest area.
Mm-hmm.
Move the AD pads to the up, down, or to the left, to the right. Don't put it on there.
Mm-hmm.
Piercings, that goes for piercings also.
Try to get the, okay.
Yeah, because we don't, that's metal
right.
and electricity. So you're gonna have to just play with it just a little bit. You don't know what's there until you open up that person's chest
okay.
to see what's there.
All right, well, you have given us a lot of great information.
Mm-hmm.
We learned how to do, you know, basic CPR.
Mm-hmm.
We learned about how to do the AED. We learned about the new app, Pulse Point.
Absolutely.
You know, that's a new initiative from our mayor, Muriel Bowser. And we definitely want to thank her and because she has helped facilitate and support this, as well as your fire chief.
Gregory Dean,
for all their support and facilitation. And basically, you know, helping make D.C. a safer place.
Yes, ma'am.
You know.
If someone would love to do hands-on hearts.
Yes.
Or
where can they find our information?
Go to our website, handsonhearts@dc.gov.
All right. You've heard it here. Go to handsonheart@dc.gov. And learn how to save a life. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Ms. Veronica, for having us.
Thank you. And hopefully you never want to get into a situation like that, but I feel empowered that I can help somebody.
Absolutely.
And don't be afraid to help somebody, because like they say, the life you save may be your own. Well, you can't take-